Women have long been philanthropists, but their voices were often not heard. It wasn't unusual for women to give under their husbands' names or to direct attention away from themselves by giving anonymously. It was in the 1970s, when women were creating a movement for a more equitable future, that they began to recognize the power of feminist-based philanthropy. The Ms. Foundation for Women, founded in 1972 by Gloria Steinem, Patricia Carbine, Letty Cotton Pogrebin, and Marlo Thomas, leveraged Ms. Magazine's profits to deliver funding and other strategic resources to organizations that elevated women's and girls' voices. After a few years, the foundation peeled off from the magazine to become its own nonprofit. It roared into the 1980s with a mission to encourage women's financial independence and protect their reproductive rights. In the 1990s, the Ms. Foundation highlighted women's career aspirations with its Take Our Daughters to Work Day. The foundation continued to champion causes into the new millennium: sex education, women's health, economic justice, child sex abuse. The Ms. Foundation was at the forefront, blazing the trail for so many of us. Today, the Ms. Foundation for Women focuses on the need for more philanthropic giving to organizations supporting women and girls of color. Teresa Younger, our keynote speaker, began this movement in 2014 when she became president and CEO of the foundation. While the foundation did groundbreaking work of its own, it also served as a role model for women's funds, organizations, and nonprofits doing work in their own communities. Throughout the 80s, 90s, and 2000s, groups sprang up all over the country that, like the Vermont Women's Fund, dedicated themselves to helping women and girls rise and thrive. These organizations, now numbering around 700, move money 6 times faster than other philanthropic groups. Today, the Vermont Women's Fund makes its grants in 3 general categories: systems change, workforce development, and essential services. The Vermont Women's Fund is following the lead of the Ms. Foundation and its work on racial equity grantmaking, learning from its many years of experience. One such program is Susu Community Farm, the first and only Afro-Indigenous farm, healing, and education center in Windham County.
We offer programs, opportunities, ritual, and ceremony to connect people back with the land, back with to their relationship with ancestral practice, and to the skills and tools needed to heal from the trauma of colonization and racialized trauma. One of the programs we launched last year during the pandemic was our BIPOC CSA, which is a free CSA program for BIPOC folks in Windham County that offers culturally relevant Afro-Indigenous heritage crops that we grow here in Vermont.
Our workforce development programs often seek to empower women to work in better paying jobs traditionally occupied primarily by men, but they also help to provide Vermont with workers our economy desperately needs to continue working for all of us. Programs like Let's Grow Kids, which supports early childhood education providers.
Early childhood education is so essential, especially in these times when people are really coming out of that pandemic and trying to get back into the workforce. We're facing a lot of challenges when it comes to childcare right now. There's a lot of programs that are having to close because they're not able to sort of support those staffing needs. Vermont Women's Fund has helped work with Let's Grow Kids, and that's been a really pivotal part for us changing the way that people in society and in our local communities are looking at early childhood education.
Our third category for giving is support for essential services. Grantees in this category provide the most vulnerable Vermont women with food, shelter, and other services to stabilize their lives. One such organization is Umbrella, which works to keep Vermonters in the Northeast Kingdom free from abuse and oppression. Its Youth in Power program prepares teens for the workplace.
Why did you want to participate in YIP specifically?
I think with YIP, they give you the platform to make a difference wherever you want. They gave me the foundational skills where I can stand up for myself more and stand up for others as well. I knew that I could interact with adults rather than being dictated by them. So I feel like I'm a larger voice now.
With all our grants, we work toward the vision advanced by the Ms. Foundation, using our collective contributions, no matter how small, to create a force for change.